we can sit down. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
We can go to our seats. Praise and worship team. Don't go far, please. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. God is good.
All the time.
And all the time. Briefly, I want to testify to God. And this is the instruction of the pastor. Amen.
Amen.
God has been so awesome to every one of us. Amen. I know the same thing He's doing for me, He's also doing it for the whole church. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And if yours hasn't come, amen.
Amen.
David said, you prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemy.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So
amen.
God is preparing your own. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
First of all, I want to start with, this was last month ago. I told Pastor that I would like to testify, but unfortunately, I didn't remind him again because he has so many things coordinating everything. Sometimes he might forget. There was a court case that, you know, I got into, and maybe sometimes if I'm saying this, it seems as if I'm maybe over exaggerating, but the Bible says the witness of one or two people is true. If my wife was around here, I mean, she would have testified to this. I've been going through this court case. A lot of people think it's over. It was over for a very long time, since 2013 till last month. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And costed me strength. Taught me how to pray, taught me how to lean on God, costed me money. If I'm talking of money, I'm talking of money, more than 20,000 euro. But every day you still see us, we shine. God is giving us strength to shine. I don't know how you think about it. At the end of the, when you're walking, after walking, 800, 900 euro will be taken from your money, from the company. And at the end, God gave me victory. He made the people to know that the accusations against me, they were just false. And not only that, God has crowned me also by saying, some of those money, I'm not really interested in having the money back, but I'm only interested in having my peace and my joy. But God also went further to say some of those money they took from me forcefully, they should pay it back.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. And God has been awesome. Last week on top, amen, when we were walking through to see that my mother-in-law will come to at least take care of the newborn baby, and I know it's going to give my wife a joy. When she said it, I said, okay, let's pray. And afterwards, I told Pastor, I said, okay, we are planning for something like this. And when she was interviewed, I also told Pastor on Sunday, before Monday she went, I said, my mother-in-law will be going for interview on Monday. So she went there, everything was easy. There was not much, it didn't last up to how many minutes, ma'am? Up to 15 minutes. They asked her to get this. Okay, we sent it, and they said, okay, come and pick up your visa. Even the, she left 4 days after. When you look at the visa, 4 days after they issued the visa. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I went to the airport. My wife in the morning, she called me that she's having, not pain. She said she's having komisch druck. That was the way she put it. I said, okay, leave it. Let's pray. I said, remember, the doctor gave us that she's going to give birth on the 5th of December. But I said, I am the father of the child, and this baby will come in November. She laughed and said, let us watch. And it was the last day of November. And she said, okay, she's having this komisch druck. I said, don't do anything. Go and relax so that you're not, nobody to take care of you, so that you not get into, you know, many troubles having this baby. And okay, she went back to bed. She didn't call me again. That was 8 o'clock in the morning when we spoke, or some minutes after 8. She said immediately we finished speaking, she went to bed. And all of a sudden, she had that thing again, just like baby tongue again. She said, this is normal. But her mind told her, call a brother. She called a brother, and the brother said he was taking his car to the mechanic. And the brother called Dr. Victor Emerson. Now then, he was just a brother, Brother Victor, our assistant pastor. So, Brother Victor said, okay, he's coming. Brother Victor, I don't even know how to tell the story. All I know is that the Bible said that our women should give birth like Hebrew women. And this is the time I'm experiencing it. And this is what we've been asking God for. Praise the Lord. And I know God is going to do it for every one of us here. So by the time Brother Victor came up, I know I was, you know, I'm still wondering how confused he will still be that day. Running up and down, trying to hold his, crying. And my wife was just there. My wife said she didn't know how she managed to open the door for Brother Victor to come in. Brother Victor came in, was trying to hold his, was trying to do this. Before Brother Victor turned around, the baby was out. Hallelujah. They called the ambulance. It wasn't up to 5 or 6 minutes.
About 8 minutes.
And I asked my wife, did you push? She said, nothing. And the baby was out. So it was Bro Victor, Dr. Victor, that he was a doctor. I mean, God is awesome. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He called me, he said, congratulations. Your wife just put to bed. I said, don't do me 419. Because I did it with him during the time of faith. So he, and he said he's good with Aliet. I didn't believe him. So when he called Naomi Oluchi, I said, yes, this is true. Now you're saying the truth. And that time I just got to the port to pick my mother-in-law. So she came out, the news I gave her was the babies. Hallelujah. So I give thanks to God. I give glory to God. See, power belongs to you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's give glory to God. Amen.
Amen.
Power belongs to you. In heaven and on earth, all power belongs to you. Everybody will sing. Sing power.